would suggest a plumber in the line. Thank you. Then if I can personal foul on the play, number 55, Caden Newton. Number 2, Addison McVicker. Reports in the Panthers lineup will be Panthers ball on the end line.
Thank you.
Jasmine Plummer will be returning to the court following the Panthers timeout. Back into the Viking lineup, the Viking ball. Got a bike conversion valve on the plate, number 21, Eldora. Pushes the tail of Fox at the line. Number 21, maybe Mackie into the Panthers lineup. Sessions stands open in the main lobby. Restroom.
Thank you. Four seconds. Thank you.
Caden Newman returns to the mic and line. Timeout.
which we don't need it right now because we've figured out how to use the huddle cam. I just don't think it's not showing up yet because that doesn't start until 7:30.
Here we go.
right now is trying to figure out what tomorrow is really lost. So once everybody, once the game starts, they follow it pretty well. Brady, when do you want to go?
WVSH. Before we head to the hardwood, we'd like to thank the following sponsors for making tonight's broadcast possible.
Bailey Love Mortuary, Bibas State Bank, First Federal Savings Bank, Hartford Roth Garrett Halberstadt and Garrett Law, Nove, and Wise Guys Downtown.
Now let's head to the arena for the fast-paced action of Lady Vikings basketball. On your home for Huntington North Sports, Viking Radio, 91.9 WVSH.
Welcome to Huntington North Arena at Bob Straight Court. Tonight, the Huntington North Lady Vikings, coached by Matt Hines, will be taking on the Eastbrook Panthers. So the Eastbrook Panthers are 13-1 on the season, while Huntington North is sitting at 9-5. Both teams have had very solid seasons, although Huntington North did lose their senior guard, Gracie Fields, recently. So that will be a big impact on the game tonight. It'll be interesting to see how that plays out offensively and defensively. But they do have Elle McDonald back from injury, who had an injury at earlier part of the season, so she'll be back. And she's been back for a couple of weeks now, but... And especially filling a big spot like that, I mean, some people have to step up as leaders, especially the seniors on this team.
Yep.
Upperclassmen are going to have to play a huge part in leadership, but also some underclassmen are going to have to step up as well for the Lady Vikes. So I got a chance to talk to Coach Hines before the game, so I will send you to that quick interview with him that I had during halftime of the JV game.
Coach, Happy New Year.
Thank you.
So how are you trying to refocus the girls after getting back into the flow of things after Christmas break and the New Year's?
We were able to take 3 days off around Christmas and come back and get ready for the tournament. And I thought our girls had a really good week of practice. Very focused, good energy. And then we were able to come out, with a couple of wins this last Saturday. So. I think our girls are dialed in. We've had some pretty energetic and focused practices and been competing. So they've done a lot of it themselves. I really haven't had to try to get them refocused. And that's the mark of a good team, is if your kids come in and dial it in and have good leadership. That's been kind of a staple here as of late. So hopefully that continues.
Yeah. So offensively and defensively and leadership in general, you lost one of your top leaders, Gracie Fields.
Yeah.
So how are you going to help replace her, and who do you want to step up in her place and help contribute in different ways?
Well, the contribution is going to have to come from everybody just doing a little more. It's not any one person that's going to do it, but she does so many things on both ends of the court for us. It's going to have to be by committee. So. We just got to be a little tougher, a little more aggressive, be a little more sure of passes, of taking the right shot. But we can't be fearful either. We have to attack and keep playing how we have been. And Abby Groove's going to step into the starting role. And, I don't know. It depends on how it goes. We might see Harper Bailey get some minutes here and there off the bench for us. So, you always have to be ready. Your number's always ready. You got to be ready when your number's called. And our girls have done that all year. We were without Elle early on, so Abby stepping in the starting role is not unfamiliar to her. She had a good game against Wallace on Saturday as well. So, in fact, if she doesn't come out and play the way she did, that game may be a different story. So, certainly have confidence in her, and the team does as well. We're going to move forward, and in the meantime, keep praying and trying to keep Gracie up. Gracie's going to be Coach Fields for a while until we can figure out the timeline on this.
So what's the game plan tonight to try to shut down this very powerful offense of that Eastbrook has?
We got to get back. The big thing is getting back and stopping them in transition. And then once you get them stopped, you got to keep them out of the paint. Got to keep them out of the paint. You know, they are a really good shooting team. They're quick. And, you know, we've got to do a good job of making sure off their ball screen coverage that they're not turning the corner and getting into the lane. So if we can do that, you know, I think that'll help our chances. But you got to pick your poison. You know, you take away the three or the paint, it's really hard to do both. So we're going to try to keep them out of the paint tonight.
All right. So finally, what are the keys tonight to a Lady Vikings victory?
Well, we got to keep them out of the paint. Like I mentioned, protect the lane. We also have to make sure that we play with sureness, just making sure that we're sure of the pass, take care of it. We don't want a high turnover game. And then they're a really good free throw shooting team. I think they're 70-some percent as a team. So we don't want to put them on the line. So we want to be aggressive without fouling. I think it's going to be important.
Awesome. Thank you very much, Coach. Good luck tonight.
All right. Thank you.
Welcome back here to North Arena. And after you heard the interview with Coach Hines, you can tell that he thinks very highly of these girls and that he really just loves them and that he cares about them and he just wants them to succeed. That's where he's coming from. He just wants them to be the best that they can be. So tonight, the starters for the Huntington North Lady Vikings will be number 4, Elle McDonald, number 11, Hayden Bailey, number 14, Grace Michael, number 24, Marissa Trout. And like we said, Gracie Fields tonight is injured, will not be playing. So number 34, Abby Grub, will step into her spot. And for the Eastbrook Lady Panthers, number 12, Courtney Goff, the senior guard. Number 20, Olivia Howell, the senior forward. Number 22, Audrey Prater, the senior guard. Number 24, Sophia Morrison, the senior guard. And then number 30, Esta McKim, the senior forward. So tonight, that will be very important to see how that plays out. We will be right back after the national anthem. So, Ryan, tonight, what do you think the Lady Vikings need to do to come out on top against this very solid, one-loss, 13-win Lady Panther team?
I mean, just back up what Coach said. Play with sureness, limit fouls, protect the paint. I mean, just play some good D. You got to play fast-paced, sure offense, and you just got to limit the fouls.
Yep, I think you are right. So, how was your Christmas, Ryan?
It was great.
It was a great Christmas.
What about you?
Oh, it's always nice to be off of school, have some time away from that. And I'm sure you passed all your classes, passed all your finals.
Flying colors.
Absolutely. Flying colors. So, like I said, number 12, Courtney Goff, number 20, Olivia Howell, number 22, Audrey Prater, number 24, Sophia Morrison, number 30, Esta McKim, will all be starting for the Lady Panthers tonight. It looks like the Lady Panthers do have a lot of upperclassmen. Actually, they are all seniors that will be starting tonight. So that is very good to have as a team. It's nice to have a lot of leadership and a lot of experience, whereas the Lady Vikings don't necessarily have as much experience on that end. I think it is Abby Groob's first year playing varsity.
Yeah.
Grace Michaels' first year, Faith along Mitten. With Faith Mitten. And then Riley Wilson and Harper Bailey also. But they do have some experience with L. McDonald playing for quite a few years. And then Marissa Chow, obviously. And then Hayden Bailey also are pretty experienced players on that end. I will be very intrigued to see how the Lady Vikes will handle offensively, how they'll handle not having one of their top scorers, Gracie Fields, because obviously she just plays such a big role in the Lady Vikings offense. And it's just really that she starts everything. She is the point guard of this team. But I think Hayden Bailey will do a good job of stepping into that role. And then Abby Grube will kind of take Hayden Bailey's spot, which was catch and shoot, and which was knocking down those wide open three-pointers that the Lady Vikings offense can get sometimes. I am pretty surprised with the amount of students that are here, as it is winter break. It's always nice to see the students come out and support their fellow student athletes.
Absolutely.
Our thanks to Memphis State Bank for being our sponsor tonight. Let's play ball.
And the Lady Vikes number 24, Marissa Trout, will win the tip. Lady Vikings moving around. Trout gets the ball at the logo. Swings it to the right wing to Abby Grube. Abby Grube swings it cross court to Hayden Bailey. Bailey and Grube going back and forth. Grube's pass to Trout is intercepted by number 24, Sophia Morrison. And she puts up a layup on the other end, and it is no good. Early turnover there by the Lady Vikes. That's not always great to see. Oops. And there is another turnover. So Coach Hines said in the pregame interview, limiting turnovers will be very important tonight for the Lady Vikes.
Right now, these first two possessions the Lady Vikes had, it looks like they're a little confused or a little rushed or something.
Like they could be missing some leadership, maybe a point guard. And then there is a basket on the other end by number 20, Olivia Howell. That is the first points of the ball game. Panthers lead it 2-0 with 6:55 left here in the first quarter. Trout now swings it to the left corner. Abby Grube. Grube drops it down to Trout on the baseline. Trout's pass into the lane to Michael is just a bit too high. It will be another turnover here by the Lady Vikes. Number 22, Prater, passing it down. Finds number 20, Olivia Howell. Olivia Howell gets it to 30. Estama Kim puts up shot and no good, but an offensive rebound there by the Lady Panthers. And they'll get another and then find Estama Kim wide open for a basket underneath the hoop. That was three offensive rebounds there for the Lady Panthers. It's not great to see, but I think the Lady Vikes will be able to overcome that. And on the offensive side of the floor for the Lady Vikes, number 34, Abby Grube, will be called for a traveling violation. There is another turnover there for the Vikes. Hopefully they can get that cleaned up and get on a roll. Number 24, Sophia Morrison being guarded by Bailey. Kicks it out to 12, Courtney Goff. Goff drives it and kicks out. Her pass is intercepted by Bailey. Bailey pushing the pace, gets a layup on the other end, and it is good. Great job there by Bailey, being able to get in the passing lanes and being able to knock down the open layup on the other end. Morrison driving it down, passes it to McKim. McKim's dribble tipped away by Bailey. Good defense there by Bailey. Morrison gets the ball, being guarded by Bailey. And then there is a shot put up, and it is no good. It is out of bounds off the Lady Vikings. They said it was blocked. So here, number 22, Audrey Prater, will pass the ball in, being inbound, being guarded by Trout. Her pass goes straight into the hands of Michaels. It looks like Trout will try to push the pace. Dribble gets stopped up, but she is able to push it down the floor. Elle McDonald now has it in the corner, passes it to Trout. Trout swings it to Bailey on the left wing. Bailey drives baseline, drops it to Michael. Michael puts up a layup, and it's no good. That was a good opportunity for the Vikes there, but they are not able to come out with any points. Morrison now has it, being guarded by McDonald. They get the switch. Passes it to McKim. McKim being guarded by Bailey. Morrison gets the ball at the top of the key, being guarded by 14, Grace Michael. Swings to the left wing to Goff. Goff dribbles, sidesteps, passes it to McKim. McKim to Howell. Howell to Morrison on the right wing. Morrison crosses over to the middle. Kicks over to 12, Goff. Goff puts up a three, and it is good. That is a good three-pointer there by the Lady Panthers. The score is now 7-2 with 4:20 left here in the first. Group's pass there is intercepted by number 24, Morrison. Morrison has been active tonight early for the Lady Panthers. Morrison has on the right wing. Passes to McKim at the top of the key. McKim to Goff. Goff puts up a deep three, and it is no good. Rebound brought down by Grace Michael. Trout's pushing the pace on the other end. Passes it to McDonald. McDonald finds Bailey at the top. Bailey to Michael in the lane. Michael's pass to Grube is intercepted. Yet another turnover there by the Lady Vikes. The Lady Panthers have not made the Lady Vikings pay for their turnover, which partly is due to the good defense by the Lady Vikes, but also due to the Lady Panthers missing some open shots. Number 12, Goff drives baseline, puts up a shot, and is fouled there by number 34, Abby Grube. Number 22, Prater, to pass the ball in for the Vikes. I mean, for the Panthers. Faith Mitten, number 21, and number 12, Riley Wilson, will check in for the Lady Vikes. Prater passes the ball in, finds number 20, Howe. But it will be Lady Panthers ball as number 21, Faith Mitten, steps out of bounds while trying to save the ball. So it will be Lady Panthers ball, scores 7-2 with 3:15 left here in the first. McDonald guarding McKim. McKim passes it out to Howe. Howe being guarded by Mitten. Mitten. Ooh, sorry. Morrison now has it at the top of the key. Puts up a layup, and it is no good. And then there's a tough fall there by Howe as Howe falls, but the Lady Vikes push the pace on the other end and get an easy layup. That was a surprising no call there by the officials, but Lady Vikings fans will not complain. Number 20, Howe, hit the ground there real hard. We'll see how that plays out the rest of the ball game. Wilson, the freshman, has it, passes it to Trout. Trout to Mitten. Mitten back to Trout. Trout cross court to the right wing to Bailey. Bailey swings it to Trout. Pass is tipped. Trout being guarded by two. Finds Bailey. Bailey to Wilson. Wilson to Trout. Lady Vikings need to try to get inside of the paint. Try to get some open shots inside. Lady Vikes do turn the ball over again. Lady Panthers will now have the ball. Number 20, Howe drives in, kicks out to Morrison. Morrison to number 12, Courtney Goff. Goff pivots, kicks it out to Morrison. Morrison now has that at the top of the key. Being guarded by number 11, Hayden Bailey. Morrison trying to create. Kicks to McKim. McKim puts up a layup, and it goes off the side of the backboard. No good. Number 11, Hayden Bailey gets the rebound and then pushes the pace for the Lady Vikes, but the ball is tipped out from behind by number 24, Morrison. Does a good job there defensively by the Lady Panthers, being able to get back and shut down the Lady Vikings' quick approach on offense. Number 24, Morrison, puts up a three, and it is no good. Trout will come down with the rebound. It looks like the Lady Vikes aren't necessarily quite sure what to do offensively. They look a little bit lost. They're trying to create something, but have not been able to yet. Trout at the top, kicks it to Bailey on the right wing. Bailey to the left corner to Wilson. Wilson to Trout. Trout back to Bailey. Bailey to McDonald in the corner. Faith Minton gets it down low. Passes it to Bailey. Bailey's layup is no good. It will be Lady Vikings ball in their backcourt after the Lady Panthers rebounder was out of bounds when she got the rebound. Scores 4-7 with 43 seconds left here in the first quarter. Off the inbound pass, Hayden Bailey has a three-point opportunity, and bang, she knocks it down. Great job there by Bailey, being able to knock down the open three-pointer off the inbounds play. Number 24, Morrison, being guarded by the freshman Wilson, finds Goff on the left wing. Goff spins, kicks it out, 20. Olivia Howell. Howell puts up a three, and it is no good. Rebound brought down by L. McDonald. McDonald settling down, passes it to Bailey. Bailey drives, kicks to Trout. Trout puts up a deep three, and it is no good. 9 seconds left here in the first quarter. Looks like Howell will push the pace. Finds Goff. Goff, number 22, Prater. Prater puts up a deep three, and it is no good. That is the end of the first quarter. Score is 7-7. Ball game is tied. So, Ryan, what there did you see from the Lady Vikings that you think that they can improve on this coming quarter and throughout the rest of the ball game?
You know, one thing that stood out to me was all the turnovers. I mean, it looked like left and right the Lady Panthers were, I mean, just doing everything they can. And I think the Lady Vikes need some spark on offense. Because defensively right now, they're preventing them from scoring fairly well. But I think on offense, we just need a little something to help us score.
Yep, whether that be some back cuts or whether that just be like simple screens. We need something to make a spark offensively to get this Lady Vikings offense going.
Absolutely. I think the Lady Vikes are also struggling right now since Gracie Fields out with the ankle injury.
Yep, I think that is part of the reason why they're struggling offensively a little bit. Coach Hines said that she might have broken her foot, so that is the injury that is keeping her out. It looks like Lady Panthers will have the ball here. Number 22, Audrey Prater passes it into number 24, Morrison. 22, Prater dribbles it around. Gives it to Morrison on the handoff. Morrison being guarded by Trout. Screen set by number 44, Mia Bustos. Morrison has the top of the key being guarded by Mitt. Morrison to Howe. Howe in the corner to Goff. And then there is a jump ball called there, and it will be Lady Vikings ball. Great job there by Faith Mitten coming over on the help and being able to take away the ball from the Lady Panthers. Wilson now has it, dribbling it down. Trout gets it, passes it to Bailey. Bailey, pump fakes. Swings it to the right wing to Trout. Trout, the middle of the court to Wilson. Trout gets it back on the right wing. In the right corner to Bailey. Trout cuts. In the left corner to McDonald. McDonald puts up a three. Bang, she knocks it in. Great job there by the Lady Vikings. Cutting, getting inside, and the kicking out to the open shooter there, which was number 4, L. McDonald. Number 24, Morrison passes it. Number 20, Howell. Howell's pass to number 12, Goff, is intercepted by Bailey. She dribbles in on the other end, finds Trout open in the corner. Good ball movement there by the Vikes. Hayden Bailey steps inside. Puts up two layups, and then there's a foul called on her after the rebound.
6:40 left here in the second quarter. Scores 10-7. Lady Vikings lead it. Number 24, Morrison, bringing the ball down the court. Hands it off to number 12, Goff. Goff drives in, kicks to the left wing to Morrison. Morrison puts up a three ball, and it is no good. Number 4, Al McDonald brings down the rebound. Pushing the pace on the other end. Kicks it out to Mitten. Mitten passes it to Trout. Trout in the left wing, passes it down to McDonald. McDonald. Left corner, passes it out to Bailey. Bailey to Wilson on the right wing. Wilson in the corner to Trout. Trout puts up a three. It's no good, just long there on the three ball from Trout. Howell pushes the pace on the other end. Howell passes it to number 22, Prater. Prater heads it back off to Howell. Howell to Morrison on the left wing. Drives in, puts up a shot, and it is no good. Rebound brought down by number 44, Mia Bustos, and she puts up a shot, and she is fouled there by number 11, Hayden Bailey. She will have two free throws here coming up. The Lady Panthers are a very good free throw shooting team. It will be big to see how they shoot from the stripe tonight. First one is up and good. Number 2, Harper Bailey, will come in here for Hayden Bailey.
Second, Harper Bailey reports in for the Vikings.
Second free throw on the way. And it is good. Knocks it in. There is a timeout there by the Lady Panthers. Scores 10-9 with 5:40 left here in the second quarter. We will send you to a quick PSA and then be right back.
Here's a fun fact for you. The average chameleon can point their eyes in two different directions. On the other hand, the average human can't. So unless you're a chameleon, there's absolutely no way you can focus on texting and driving at the same time. So don't do it, unless you're a chameleon.
Visit stoptextsstoprex.org. A message brought to you by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration, Project Yellow Light, and the Ad Council.
We bring you back to Huntington North Arena, Bob Strait Court, where the Lady Vikings lead the Lady Panthers with 5:42 left in this ballgame. Or sorry, in this half. Not the ballgame, in this first half. It looks like it will be number 24, Marissa Trout, to pass the ball in. Freshman Wilson gets it, bringing it down the court. Being guarded by number 24, Sophia Morrison. Harper Bailey passes it to Al McDonald on the left wing. Trout gets in the corner, being guarded by Howe. Howe gets it to Wilson. Screen set there by Mitten, and then McDonald gets it in the right corner. Riley Wilson has it at the top of the key, the right wing to Trout. Trout trying to create, doesn't find anything. Passes it over to the left wing to McDonald. McDonald to the freshman Wilson. McDonald gets it back. Passes it to Bailey. Harper Bailey. McDonald gets it the right wing to Trout. Trout drives in, drops it down to Mitten. Mitten puts up a layup, and it is no good. Good defense there by number 44, Mia Bustos. Number 12, the freshman, Wilson, being guarding number 24, Sophia Morrison. Morrison drops it to Howe, and Howe drops in a nice layup there. That will put the Lady Panthers up by one with 4:20 left here in second quarter. Score is 10-11. Lady Panthers lead it. It will be Wilson. Down low, kicks it out to McDonald. McDonald passes low for McDonald. And number 2, Harper Bailey. And then number 20, Olivia Howell is tied up. It will be Lady Panthers ball. Number 12, the freshman, Wilson. guarding number 24, Morrison. Morrison to Howe. Howe to Goff. Goff to Morrison. Morrison drives in. Shot is blocked, but comes up with the rebound. And the ball will be out of bounds off of the Lady Vikings. It will be Lady Panthers' ball with 3:45 left under their own basket. Number 22, Prater, passed the ball in. Passes it in to Goff. Goff in the corner, being guarded by Harper Bailey. And good defense there by Bailey. The ball will be out of bounds off of the Eastbrook Lady Panthers. Trout passes it in Wilson. Wilson back to Trout. Trout to Harper Bailey. Harper Bailey to McDonald. McDonald to Wilson. Gets it down low to Michael. Michael pivots, kicks it out. Trout gets it in the right corner. Drives in. Puts up a left-handed hook shot, and good shot there by Marissa Trout, being able to use her taller frame, being able to make a spin move and get around the Lady Panthers defender. And then on the other end, number two, Harper Bailey gets a rebound, and number four, Elle McDonald, pushes the pace, has an open layup on the other end, but is not able to knock it in. Number 24, Morrison, now has it. Passes the left wing to Howe. Howe to the right wing to Prater. Prater gets it to Morrison, top of the key. Being guarded by the freshman, Wilson. Hands it off to Goff. Hands it off to Howe. Howe to Goff. Goff to Morrison on the right wing. Drives to the free throw line. Kicks it out to Howe. Good defense there by the Lady Vikes. Freshman Wilson plays good defense. And number two, Harper Bailey, is able to get the steal. Drops it down to Trout on the other end, and that is a good bucket there by the Lady Vikings. Scores 14-11 with 2:02 left here in the second quarter. Morrison being guarded by Wilson. Wilson, or Morrison, drops it down to number 44, Bustos. Bustos puts a layup over the smaller defender, number two, Harper Bailey, and is able to knock down the two-pointer. Scores 14-13, 1:30 left here in the second quarter. Harper Bailey has it on the left wing. Trying to find an open teammate. Finds Trout in the corner. Trout dribbles in, picks up her dribble, jump stops. Puts up a shot, and it is no good, but the rebound's brought down by Michael, and her shot also is just a bit strong. Lady Panthers push the pace on the other end and knock down an open three-pointer there. Sophia Morrison knocks it down the triple for the Lady Panthers. Trout dribbles it down. Right corner. Bailey. Bailey to McDonald. Screen set there by Michael. McDonald gets on the right wing in the right corner to Trout. Trout trying to create. Find some open space. Gets it to McDonald in the right corner. Bailey dribbles it down low, trying to find someone open. And that is a 3-second violation there called on the Lady Vikings. The freshman, Bailey, was not quite there. Didn't have the court awareness. But that's not going to kill the Vikings, as it is only a 2-point ball game with 35 seconds left here in the first half. Scores 16-14. Lady Vikings trailing the Lady Panthers. Number 24, Morrison, passes it to number 30, McKim. Prater gets it, dribbles down the right block. McKim gets it, top of the key, puts up a floater and is no good. Rebound brought down by Grube, but she cannot hold on to it and is out of bounds off of Grube. 10 seconds left here. We'll see if the Lady Vikings can get a defensive stop. So, Ryan, what do you think the Lady Vikings need to do to get themselves leading this ball game, get into control, and find a way to come out on top.
I think the Lady Vikes just need to keep their composure, you know, just talk with each other on the court, you know, just follow your assignment, like I said before, but also don't let up on silly mistakes, such as like ball handling and, you know, stuff like that, like passes.
Yep, I agree. I think they need to limit some turnovers that they're having. And then I think that that'll really just help them be in control of this ball game. And then throughout the rest of the game, we'll see how that goes. 4 seconds left here for the Lady Vikes. 3, 2, 1. Trout puts up a shot from half court, and it is no good there. Lady Vikings trailed the Lady Panthers 14-18 here at the end of the first half. Ryan, what was really the biggest thing you saw that created problems for the Lady Vikings?
Honestly, I think their defense was the biggest problem. I mean, like, we had to space out our offense, and it looked like our girls were kind of confused on what to do in that situation. Their defense was overwhelming, and they put up a lot of shots. Offensively, they put up a lot of shots. Most of them are very smart and good shots on the court.
Yeah, I think that the Lady Panthers defense did a really good job of confusing the Lady Vikings offense. As I try to find this week's episode of Commissioner's Corner, Ryan, what do you think that the Lady Panthers have done that have put them on top so far throughout this walk?
I mean, the record also speaks for how well they play. I mean, it looks like they all know what they're doing, like what their assignment is, you know, whether that's defensively, offensively. They protect the paint very well, and I think they just work very well as a team, and they all know what they're doing.
Yep, I would agree. So we will send you to some quick underwriters here at the end of the first half. You're listening to Huntington North Lady Viking Basketball on 91.9 WVSH.
A portion of today's broadcast is brought to you by Bippus State Bank. With 4 locations, including 2 branches in Huntington, 1 in North Manchester, and a branch in Roanoke, Bippus State Bank is an independent community bank. Thank you, Bippus State Bank, for your continued support of our broadcast. A portion of today's broadcast is brought to you by Courtney Martz, local Indiana Farm Bureau insurance agent. For auto, home, renters, life, business, and farm and crop insurance, Courtney can be contacted at 260-356-2522, extension 3528, or by visiting infarmbureau.com. Thank you, Courtney Martz at Indiana Farm Bureau, for your support of our broadcasts. A portion of today's broadcast is brought to you by Nove. Headquartered in Markle, Nove is one of the nation's largest manufacturers of utility trailers. More information can be found online at www.novecorp.com or in person by visiting the I-69 Trailer Center near the junction of State Road 224 and I-69 in Markle. Thank you, Nove, for your support of our broadcasts.
Today's broadcast is brought to you by attorneys at Harper, Roth, Garrett, Halverstad, and Garrett, with offices in Huntington, Roanoke, and Warren. The attorneys at Harper, Roth, Garrett, Halverstad, and Garrett provide a full range of legal services to the Huntington community. More information can be found by visiting www.hrg.law or by calling 260-356-4100. Thank you for your support.
A portion of today's broadcast is brought to you by Wise Guys Downtown. Located on Cherry Street in downtown Huntington, Wise Guys offers a taste of Italy in every bite. Reservations can be made by calling 260-200-1056. Updated menus and more information can be found by visiting www.marineradealer.com. Thanks, Wise Guys Downtown, for your support of WVSH. A portion of today's broadcast is brought to you by Bailey Love Mortuary. Located at the corner of West Park Drive and Cherry Street in downtown Huntington, Bailey Love has been family-owned and operated since 1910. More information about Bailey Love's services can be found online at www.baileylove.com. Thank you, Bailey Love Mortuary, for your support of WVSH.
The impact of a meal goes well beyond feeding our bodies. Because feeling full can sound like this.
How did the interview go?
I did it! I got the job! I can't believe it!
And like this.
Mom, I got first place at the science fair with my volcano project.
That's amazing, sweetie. Congratulations.
Because when people are fed, futures are nourished, and everyone deserves to live a full life. Join the movement to end hunger at feedingamerica.org/act now. Brought to you by Feeding America and the Ad Council.
It's time for the Commissioner's Corner,
an
exclusive weekly conversation about Indiana high school sports with the Commissioner of the IHSAA, Paul Neidig. Now for an up-to-the-minute report about what's happening in the constantly changing world of high school sports, here's Coach Bob Lovell with Commissioner Paul Neidig.
Welcome back, everyone, to our weekly conversation about the IHSAA. Sitting in to this week will be Assistant Commissioner Brian Lewis in for Paul Neidig. And Brian, thanks for taking time to be with us, and I hope your holidays were great.
Coach, I appreciate you having me on, and same to you, and Happy New Year to everybody listening.
Big new year for everyone in the IHSAA, winter sports in full swing. And you know, over the holidays, it was a perfect time to go watch swimming and wrestling and basketball in various parts of the state. It's a fun time of year for everyone, is it not?
Oh, it's a great time of year. You know, you get some people that get away and be able to spend time with family, but then there's enough basketball games, I know for sure, over a two-week period here to keep you busy. And so, you know, it's a great time to get out and support your local school and watch education-based athletics. And I was able to get out and see quite a few basketball games over the break, and it's always good to see student athletes at their best.
Well, while you were out, you were watching games and being impressed and in the middle of all the action. And one of the administrative responsibilities you have at the IHSAA is you oversee boys basketball, and you also oversee the officiating program. And we're at a crucial time as a state, and you are as an association, because there don't seem to be enough officials on the horizon. There looms a possible shortage of certified and registered officials. Is that correct?
That's absolutely correct. And I think it's, you know, it's not something that's specific to Indiana. It's one of those issues that has been monitored across the country for quite some time. And we've been able to stage it off a little bit longer than some others, but it's one of those things that we keep our eye on. And we really have a focus on recruiting new officials and younger officials to get into the profession. And at the same time, be able to train them properly so that it's something that they can do for longevity. You know, that we lose officials sometimes within the first 2 or 3 years. If we can get them to 3 years, we got a chance to keep them for a really long time. And so I do want to say thank you to all those officials that dedicate their time and efforts and time away from their families to allow our kids the opportunity to compete in education-based athletics.
Brian Lewis with us from the IHSAA. We're talking about officiating. Well, how is the recruitment effort going for you right now?
Recruitment effort's a 365-day job for all of us. And, you know, we have some exciting things going on. We have officials that work recruiting tents at all of our state finals events. Over the last 2.5 years, we've partnered with a company called Ref Reps that has produced a curriculum that is online, that is digital, interactive, where students have the opportunity to go in from the vision of an official and make the call and learn how to be an official and the basic mechanics and signals, et cetera. But students have the ability to do that within their high school day and receive high school credit as well as earn a provisional license through the IHSAA. So that's an exciting program that we've got right now in over 70 schools across the state of Indiana to hopefully get young kids involved so that when they graduate high school and they go to college, this may be something they choose to do to make a little extra money on the side and get involved at an early age and continue to do for many years. And so that's a really exciting program, and the IHSA Foundation has done a great job of supplementing
Broadcasting from room 104 of the Huntington North High School building.
A broadcast service of the Huntington County Community School Corporation.
Viking Radio, 91.9 WVSH.
Welcome back to North Arena, Bob Strait Court. That was this week's episode of Commissioner's Corner with IHSAA Commissioner Paul Needig. You're listening to Huntington North Radio, Lady Vikings basketball on Viking Radio, 91.9 WVSH. So the Lady Panthers lead the Lady Vikes 18-14 here at the start of the third quarter. Ryan, what do you think the Lady Vikings need to do to get control of this ballgame, get the lead, and then hopefully come out on top?
I think first and foremost, they just need to control the ball a little bit more, especially offensively against this hard defense. Like Harper Bailey, Hayden Bailey, they both have had some nice ball control movement as point guards so far in this game. And I think just limiting turnovers would also help.
Yep, I agree. Limiting those turnovers, creating some offense, and just having ball control throughout the whole game. And there is a nice three ball by Marissa Trout. That is a great start to the half by the Lady Vikings. That puts them at 1 point away from bringing this game back to even. On the Lady Panthers end, number 30, McKim has it. Swings to the left wing to Morrison. Morrison to number 22, Audrey Prater. Prater to Howell. Howell puts up a three ball, and it is no good. Rebound brought down there by Abby Groob. Groob passes to Bailey. Screen set for Bailey by Trout. Trout rolls, puts up a floater, is no good, and the rebound will be brought down by number 22, Audrey Prater. Prater to the left wing to Morrison. Morrison drives, steps back, puts up a three, and she knocks it in. That is a great shot there by the Lady Panthers. Number 24, Sophia Morrison, the senior guard. Bailey has it. Hands it off, gets it back. Kicks it out to Trout. Trout thinks about three, doesn't take it. Dribbles in. Kicks it out to Bailey. Bailey, McDonald. McDonald back to Bailey. Bailey drives. Puts up a layup, and it is no good. But she is able to put up another shot and is fouled. She will have two free throws here coming up after the foul call. Score is 21-17 with 6:10 left here in this third quarter. First one is up and no good. Second one on the way. Comes up just a bit short off the front iron. Number 20, Olivia Howell, comes down with it. Dribbles it down to the other end. Being guarded by Bailey. To left wing to Goff. Being guarded by Groob. Groob to Prater. Prater to McKim. McKim drives in, kicks out to Goff. Goff swings it to Prater. Prater gives it to Morrison. Morrison to Howell. Howell drives in. Drops it down to McKim. McKim kicks it out to Morrison, but is called for a travel. It will be Lady Vikings basketball here in the backcourt. Number 11, Hayden Bailey will get the ball off the inbound. Bailey drives in, kicks it out to Trout. Trout thinks about a three, doesn't take it, being guarded by Howell. Bailey gets the ball now. Cross court pass to Groob. Groob trying to get it down to Trout. Trout gets it now in the left corner. She drives to the middle, puts up a shot, and is fouled there by number 30, McKim. She will have two free throws here coming up for the Lady Vikings. There's a lot of disagreement on that foul call. A lot of people do not think that number 24, Marissa Trout, was fouled. I think they said that she got her on the arm, so she will have two free throws coming up. First one's up and good. Single one on the way, and she knocks it in. Looks like Morrison will take the ball down here for the Lady Panthers. Being guarded by Bailey. Crosses over, Euro steps, and her layup comes up just a bit short, but McKim comes down with the rebound. At number 22, Audrey Prater will have a wide open three there, but it is no good. And there will be a jump ball. It will be Lady Panthers possession off the help ball. Faith Minton and Riley Wilson will check in here for the Lady Vikes for Groob and Michael. Looks like Prater passed the ball in here for the Lady Panthers. Passes up in the air, and then number 24, Morrison, comes down with it. Morrison swings it to her teammate, number 20, Howell. Howell puts up a layup and is no good. Rebound brought down by Trout. Trout pushes the pace. Ball is stripped away by McKim. Finds a cutting Bailey, puts up a layup, and it is no good, but a foul called there on the Lady Panthers golf. Bailey will have two free throws here coming up. Bailey's first free throw is up and good. She knocks it in. Second free throw on the way. Comes up just a bit short and left. Rebound brought down by McKim. McKim being guarded by the freshman Wilson. Morrison gets on the left wing, thinks about a three, doesn't take it. Drives in, steps back, passes it to number 20, Howell. Howell to Morrison. Morrison dribbles, kicks it out to Goff. Goff shoots a three, and she knocks it in. That is a good offensive possession there by the Lady Panthers. Trout gets it. Bailey now has on the left wing. Bailey shoots a three. Her three comes up just a bit long off the back iron. It will be Lady Panthers ball. Prater now has it, kicks it to Goff. Goff to Howell. Howell to Morrison. Morrison drives in, hands it off to Goff. Goff to Prater. Prater kicks it out to Howell. Howell drives in. To the left, there's a foul call there on number... Marissa Trout. That is her first foul of the ball game. Number 24, Morrison, will pass the ball in here for the Lady Panthers. Passes it into Howell. And Howell is off of Faith Minton, out of bounds. It will be Lady Panthers ball in their front court. Number 20, Howell has it. Hands it off to Morrison. Morrison puts up a three ball and knocks it in. That is the second three of the half there by Morrison. Third or fourth of the half here for the Lady Panthers. Lady Panthers are back in their zone trap defense. Number 4, Elle McDonald is trapped in the corner. And they will call out of bounds on the Lady Vikings. Coach Hines strongly disagrees with that, but it will be Lady Panthers ball. And there is a foul called on the offensive end on number 21, Faith Minton. Lady Panthers will have the ball underneath the basket. Pass into Goff. Morrison now has it. Morrison swings it in the corner to Prater. Prater gives it to Howell. Howell drives, kicks out to Goff. Goff dribbles in, kicks out to Morrison. Morrison travels, but there is no travel call there. And then number 20, Howell will have it in the corner. Kicks out to Morrison. Morrison there for three, and she knocks it in. That is another big three there by Morrison. Morrison's knocked down quite a few of those tonight. And then there's a turnover there by Marissa Trout. That is another turnover there for the Lady Vikes. Morrison now has it. Dribbles in. Kicks out to Howell. Howell drives in, spins. Puts up a shot, and it is no good. It looks like Howell will have two free throws here for the Lady Panthers. Score is 30-20 with 2:07 left here in the third period. First one's up, and good. Ryan, what do you think the Lady Vikings need to do here to get themselves back into this ballgame?
You know, I've seen some good offensive plays by Marissa Trout. She looks kind of winded, but, you know, I think we need a couple more plays on offense and defense especially. I mean, we just got to get more pressure applied on defense, especially with all these threes they're shooting.
Mm-hmm. I agree. There's another long pass there by the Lady Vikings that's almost intercepted, but is just tipped out of bounds. It will be Lady Vikings ball in the front court. Trout to pass it in. Trout to Bailey. Bailey to Michael. Michael to Wilson. Vikings got to get inside of this tough trap defense. And there it is, number 24, Marissa Trout. Finds number 14, Grace Michael, down low inside for the easy bucket. Morrison has it, hands it off to Howell. Howell to Morrison. Morrison thinks about a three, doesn't take it. Dribbles around, kicks it to Prater. Prater to Goff. Goff to Morrison. Morrison to Prater. Prater puts up a three and is just long, but number 20, Howell comes up with the rebound. And we'll find number 24, Morrison, there for an open three, and it is no good. Rebound brought down by Trout. Trout pushes the pace, finds Bailey. Bailey puts up a nice layup there. That will cut the lead down to 8 here for the Lady Vikes. Well, the Lady Vikes are trailing by 8, cuts the Lady Panthers' lead down to 8. Morrison thinks about a three, doesn't take it, finds Prater. Prater kicks it out. Morrison passes it to Goff, to Howell in the corner. Howell drops it down. Morrison, Morrison to Prater. Prater puts up a deep three, and she knocks it in. The Lady Panthers have really stepped up and made a lot of big three-pointers here in this third quarter. Trout will have the ball. Kicks it to Bailey. Bailey in the corner to Wilson, and the freshman Wilson cannot handle it. That will be another turnover there for the Lady Vikes. 17 seconds left here in the third quarter. Coach Hines is visibly frustrated. We'll see if the Lady Vikes can get a stop here. And they do. They create a turnover. They get a travel. And then they will have 8 seconds to try to get some points on the board before the end of this third quarter. Prater gets the ball, gives it to Morrison. And then that is the end of the third quarter. Ryan, what do you think happened there to the Lady Vikes to put themselves down 11 here in this tough third quarter at the end of it?
I mean, there's nothing really that the Lady Vikes did. I think the Panthers just, they're feeling hot, you know what I'm saying? they're cooking up something. I mean, I saw a screen set by one of the players, and right behind her was Goff with the three.
Yep, she knocked down a big three there.
They're just locked in, and I think they're just playing very well right now, especially in the third period.
Yep, and I think that the Lady Vikings, they're kind of struggling right now without having one of their top players, Gracie Fields, and then it's just hard to handle that. And sometimes when you don't have one player, it makes some other players have to play more, and that's just a struggle sometimes.
Yeah.
We'll see if the Lady Vikings can come back and win this ballgame here with fourth quarter left. Lady Panthers lead the Lady Vikings 35-24 here at the start of the fourth quarter. Trout to pass the ball in. Passes it into Bailey. Bailey dribbles it. Finds Trout. Trout back to Bailey. Bailey to Trout. Trout to Bailey. Find McDonald. Trout gets it on the right wing. Passes the left wing to Mitten. Mitten gives it back to Trout. Trout to McDonald in the corner. McDonald to Bailey on the left wing. Good defense here by the Lady Panthers. Marissa Trout open in the corner, and her three-point shot comes up just a bit off the right. Lady Panthers will have the ball. Morrison has it. Dribbles. Spins out. Trying to create. Passes it to open Goff. Goff shoots a three, and it is no good. Comes up just a bit short there for the Lady Panthers. Lady Vikes 24. Trout will push it. Trout Bailey passes to Mitten. Mitten passes to Michael. Michael's pass is no good. Comes up just a bit high, and it will be another turnover there for the Lady Vikings. Score is 35-24 here with 6:50 left in the fourth quarter. Number 24, Morrison has it. She's made quite a few big three-pointers tonight. Passes it to Goff. Drives in, kicks out to Prater. Prater thinks about a three, doesn't take it. Gives it to Howell. Howell drives in. Drops it down to her teammate. 44, Mia Bustos. And it is out off of Faith Mitten. It will be Lady Panthers' ball underneath their basket. I think one of the big problems tonight for the Lady Vikings defensively is that they have not been able to really create turnovers or create good, strong defensive stops. They've allowed a lot of second chance opportunities, and that's just not a good recipe for success.
Absolutely. I mean, especially with that missing piece, Gracie Fields, I mean, she's one of the best defensive players so far this season, and without her in the game, it's very obvious to tell that.
Yep.
Is struggling a little bit.
Hayden Bailey will get the ball in the corner. Swings it across the court to Trout. Trout kicks it out to McDonald. McDonald to Bailey in the corner. Bailey across the court to Trout, and it is too high there for Trout. That is another turnover there for the Lady Vikes. Trout looks exhausted. She's been out on the court all game. She hasn't really gotten a break. I'm sure she is giving it her all right now, and she's obviously a little frustrated that her team is trailing by 11 right now. There's a wild pass there by Howell, but is tipped back to her. Goff now has it on the left block. Gets it back out to Howell. Howell hands it off to Goff. Goff kicks it out to Howell. Howell to Morrison. Morrison being guarded by McDonald. Morrison kicks it out to Prater. Prater drives in. Kicks it out to Howell on the right wing. Left wing. Morrison. Morrison dribbles to her right. Pump fakes it. Gets McDonald in the air. And then number 44, Bustos, gets it on the left block. She's able to get an easy layup there on the offensive end for the Lady Panthers. Trout has it in the lane, puts up a shot, and is fouled. She will have two free throws coming up here for the Lady Vikings. Trout's first free throw is up and good. Second free throw on the way, and she knocks it in. Good job there by Trout of being able to take advantage of the opportunities to make this game back to 11 points. That will be a timeout there by Coach Hines. That is, it looks like he's trying to get his team back under control, get them back dialed in to maybe find a way to get back into this ball game and fight and make it a closer ball game. So what do you think the Lady Vikes need to do to make that happen, Ryan?
You know, they've actually brought up the intensity a little bit more in the second half of this game. Just defending the Lady Panthers on defense, I think they're doing a lot better, actually. They're cutting the lead down a little bit more. And I think just stopping their momentum, Lady Panthers' momentum, will help, in turn, help the Lady Vikes out a little bit more.
I think you're right. I think that they have kind of taken away some of the three-pointers that the Lady Panthers were hitting earlier, and that they're trying to now make the Lady Panthers go inside. They're denying those three-point shots, and they're trying to create some turnovers, and let's see if they can get back in this ball game. Prater to pass it in, being guarded by the freshman Wilson. Passes it into Morrison. Morrison to Prater. Prater to McKim. McKim to Goff. Goff to Howe for an easy bucket on the other end. And one there by number 20, Olivia Howell. It looks like that foul will be called on Hayden Bailey. That is her third foul of the game with 4:44 left here in the fourth quarter. Howell's free throw is up, and she knocks it in. Trout has it, bringing it down the court for the Vikes. Finds McDonald here in the left corner. Score is 40-26 with 4:34 left here in the fourth quarter. McDonald passing it in. Passes it in to Bailey. Bailey to Trout. Trout to Bailey. Bailey back to Trout. Wilson in the corner. But that is a kicked ball there by number 30, McKim. It will be Lady Vikings ball underneath the basket. Trout to pass it in with 4:22 left here in the fourth quarter. Finds Bailey open. Bailey puts up a three. And it is no good there on the three-pointer from Bailey. Number 22, Prater, gets it in the corner. Dribbles it out. Passes it to Morrison. Morrison being guarded by Trout. Trout to Howe. Howe to McKim. McKim puts up a floater. And it is no good there by McKim. McDonald brings the rebound down. Bailey pushing the pace. She allows the defense to get set up by the Lady Panthers when she could have maybe attacked, but instead she pulls it out and lets the Lady Panthers defense get set up. Lady Vikings trying to create. Trout has it. Back to Wilson. Wilson. Trout. Wilson's pass is low to Trout, and Trout cannot handle it. That is another turnover there for the Lady Vikes. Morrison has it, dribbling it down for the Lady Panthers. Scores 40-26 with 3:18 left here in the fourth quarter. McKim has it. Pump fakes. Puts up a shot, and it is good there by number 30, Esta McKim. Trout has it, passes it to Bailey. Bailey to Wilson. Wilson to Trout. Trout dribbles it in, kicks it out to Wilson. Wilson to Trout. Trout and Wilson passing it back and forth. Trout drives in, kicks it to Bailey. Bailey thinks about a shot, kicks it back out to Trout. Trout puts up a three, and it is good. That's another good shot there by Marissa Trout. She's knocked down quite a few of those today, but her team has come up just a bit short this far. Score is 42-29 here with 2:20 left here in the fourth quarter. Howe passes it to Morrison. Morrison getting it down low. There's a jump ball called It will be the Lady Panthers ball, and then Coach Hines brings in an all whole new lineup. It looks like it will be number 34, Abby Group, number 2, Harper Bailey, number 14, Grace Michael, number 5, Addie Funk, and then number 55, Kata Newman. Morrison has it, being guarded by Funk. Morrison to Prater. Prater down low to Bustos. Bustos, pump fakes, kicks it out to Howe. Howe to Prater. Prater to Morrison. Howe now has on the right wing. Gets it down low to Bustos. Bustos drop steps and is able to get a nice layup there on that end. Harper Bailey trying to find something open. Finds Grace Michael. Grace Michael kicks it out to Addie Funk. And then there is another turnover there by the Lady Vikes with 1:30 left here in the fourth quarter. Scores 44-29. 1:20 left here in the ballgame. Howe has it. Puts up a layup. And then there is a travel called there on Howe. That will bring in two subs for the Lady Panthers. Looks like it will be number 14, Michaela Fox, and then number 10, Livy Engel. Harper Bailey to bring the ball down for the Vikes. Finds Grace Michael in the corner. Out to Funk. Groove on the right wing. To left wing to Michael. And then there is a double dribble there by Funk. Another turnover for the Lady Vikes. 1:05 left here in the game for the Lady Vikes. Lady Panthers lead the ball game 44-29. Morrison brings it down. Passes it to 14, Michaela Fox. Fox out to Morrison. 53 seconds left. Prater has it. Drops it down to Bustos, but there is a foul called there on number 55, Kata Newman.
Number
48 seconds left here in the ball game. Looks like number 40, AJ Brenner, will check in for the Lady Panthers. Along. Yep. Just her. Number 30, McCam will pass the ball in. Morrison has it. McKim. Then number 10, Livy Engel, puts up a shot and it is no good, but she gets her own rebound. Fox now has it. Fox crosses over, kicks out to McKim. 30 seconds left in the ball game. Pass down to number 40. AJ Brenner is intercepted. It will be Lady Vikings ball here with 20 seconds left. Bailey has it. Kicks it out to Michael. Michael to Group. Group to Funk. Funk to Bailey. Bailey down to Newman. Newman puts up an easy two there for the Lady Vikes. Brings the lead down to 13. Final score of the ball game tonight is 44-31. Lady Panthers win. Lady Vikings fall to the now 14-1. Lady Eastbrook Panthers. So we will be right back after these PSAs for an after post-game interview with Coach Hines.
How was your drive to school?
Let me tell you, I had to get my iced coffee first. I just can't seem to put it down. My favorite rapper just announced a tour. My phone was buzzing like crazy. I'm so excited. I had to text all my friends right then to talk about it. Then someone started calling me and...
Let's try that again.
I turned my phone off right away. I never drive distracted.
Visit StopTextStopRex.org, a message brought to you by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration, Project Yellow Light, and the Ad Council.
The impact of a meal goes well beyond feeding our bodies, because feeling full can sound like this.
How did the interview go?
I did it! I got the job! I can't believe it!
And like this.
Mom, I got first place at the science fair with my volcano project.
That's amazing, sweetie. Congratulations.
Because when people are fed, futures are nourished, and everyone deserves to live a full life. Join the movement to end hunger at feedingamerica.org/act now. Brought to you by Feeding America and the Ad Council.
Let's ask their parents a lot of questions.
Why can't people fly?
Gravity.
Is the moon really made of cheese?
Yep, cream cheese.
When can I move into a big kid's car seat?
For some questions, parents may not have the answer, but that's okay. They can't know everything, but knowing the right seat for their age and size will help protect them in a car crash. Find out more at nhtsa.gov/the right seat.
Where do babies come from?
Good luck, Dad. A message from NHTSA and the Ad Council.
The impact of a meal goes well beyond feeding our bodies, because feeling full can sound like this.
How did the interview go?
I did it! I got the job! I can't believe it!
And like this.
Mom! I got first place at the science fair with my volcano project!
That's amazing, sweetie. Congratulations!
Because when people are fed, futures are nourished, and everyone deserves to live a full life. Join the movement to end hunger at feedingamerica.org/act now. Brought to you by Feeding America and the Ad Council.
When it comes to making plans, you are the best. What about those round trips, which are perfect on your way there and perfect on your way back? Or those meetings with friends, surprise parties, camps, birthdays. The same way you plan for the important moments, start planning to protect you and your loved ones from a natural disaster. Sign up for local weather and emergency alerts. Prepare an emergency kit and make a family communications plan. Get started at ready.gov/plan.
Brought to you by FEMA and the Ad Council.
I'm Chris Jakimic. I served in the United States Air Force, and I deployed 3 times. Being a veteran, it's interwoven into your DNA. It is really the absence of the connection and the purpose that can really drive a lot of veterans to some negative thoughts. For those who are in a suicidal crisis, the window of time to save somebody's life is very short. Our duty is to protect ourselves and protect our families, and one way you can do that is store your weapons safely. Store all your guns securely. Help stop suicide.
Brought to you by End Family Fire and the Ad Council.
Teaching your kids about the dangers of vaping can be hard. Getting them to listen to hot gossip is easy. So here's some drama you could share with your kid. Dude, did you hear about Cassie and Jake? No, but did you hear that vaping can cause irreversible lung damage and nicotine affects brain development? Nuh-uh. You don't need to gossip if you want to have an open conversation about vaping. So if you want to get tips on when and how to talk to your kids, visit talkaboutvaping.org. Brought to you by the American Lung Association and the Ad Council.
When it comes to making plans, you are the best. What about those round trips, which are perfect on your way there and perfect on your way back? Or those meetings with friends, surprise parties, camps, birthdays. The same way you plan for the important moments, start planning to protect you and your loved ones from a natural disaster. Sign up for local weather and emergency alerts. Prepare an emergency kit and make a family communications plan. Get started at ready.gov/plan.
Brought to you by FEMA and the Ad Council.
How was your drive to school?
Let me tell you, I had to get my iced coffee first. I just can't seem to put it down. My favorite rapper just announced a tour. My phone was buzzing like crazy. I'm so excited. I had to text all my friends right then to talk about it. Then someone started calling me and...
Let's try that again.
I turned my phone off right away. I never drive distracted.
Visit StopTextStopRex.org. A message brought to you by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration, Project Yellow Light, and the Ad Council.
How was your drive to school?
Let me tell you, I had to get my iced coffee first. I just can't seem to put it down. My favorite rapper just announced a tour. My phone was buzzing like crazy. I'm so excited. I had to text all my friends right then to talk about it. Then someone started calling me and...
Let's try that again.
I turned my phone off right away. I never drive distracted.
Visit StopTextStopRex.org. A message brought to you by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration, Project Yellow Light, and the Ad Council.
Sometimes I just cannot believe all the storms we've gone through here.
I can only hope that we'll be able to leave this house to you one day, baby. You're our legacy.
Planning for these disasters will make sure we're safe, and is the best way to protect that legacy.
Protect your legacy. Visit ready.gov/plan for the tools and tips you need to start your emergency preparedness plan today. Brought to you by FEMA and the Ad Council.
Uh-oh, Brad's buzzed.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, he's starting with the woots. And now a speech.
I just want to say that friendship is about heart. Heart and brain. Who's with me?
Good thing is, he knows when he's buzzed.
And my brain is saying, when it's time to go home, somebody call me a ride.
Love that guy.
Me too.
Know your buzzed warning signs? Call for a ride when it's time to go home. Buzz driving is drunk driving. A message from NHTSA and the Ad Council.
I'm a pretty great multitasker. I can wash dishes and do laundry.
I can roller skate while walking my dog.
I can even order lunch while doing my homework. But I can't use my phone while driving. A distracted driver is one of the leading causes of death in the United States. So when it comes to driving, please, don't be a multitasker.
Don't drive distracted. A message brought to you by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration, Project Yellow Light, and the Ad Council.
So I am here with head coach Mr. Hines. So, coach, tough loss tonight. What do you think that the Lady Panthers did a good job of that gave you guys some troubles tonight?
Well, they're quick. They're active. Like I said, if they start getting in the paint, we got to help. Then it's going to be a long night because they got three kids on the court that can shoot it and shoot it deep. And they stretch the floor, and that's tough to deal with. And they did that tonight, and we didn't execute our game plan very well.
Yeah. So what do you guys think you did do a good job of tonight, even though there weren't a lot of bright sides of this ballgame?
I'm usually pretty good at finding some things. But, I'll tell you this. The five that were in at the end, I thought they played really active. I thought they played with some spirit that last 2.5 minutes or so. I was proud of those kids. But up until that point, there just wasn't much energy. I thought we played with it's not that we were being lazy, nothing like that, but playing as five individuals instead of as a group, we had an opportunity tonight to fight through some adversity, and when you do that, it strengthens you. We didn't get strengthened tonight. We didn't strengthen ourselves tonight. I thought when things got tough, we tend to turn a little bit, kind of put our heads down, and body language starting to get bad again, and you know, you just can't do that, especially against a good team.
Yeah. So going into next game against a tough opponent in East Noble, what was your message to the girls tonight?
Well, my message to the girls was just about fighting. You know, we don't surrender. You keep fighting, and you fight together. And if we don't do that, it's going to be a long last few weeks, because there's no gimmies on our schedule. So we've got to buckle down, get ready to go, and get ready for East Noble on Friday.
So is there anything else that you want the listeners to know and that you want to share?
Well, I just want to say, you know, despite all this, you know, God gives us moments to fight through adversity. It's our approach. It's E plus R equal O. It's our event plus our response to that that equals the outcome. So despite all this, he's still great. Still a lot of work to do with this team. They're still great kids, and we love them. We just got to learn from it and grow from it.
All right. Thank you, Coach. All right.
Thank you.
So thanks for tuning in to tonight's broadcast of Huntington North Lady Vikings basketball. Again, the Lady Vikings fell to the Lady Panthers tonight. I'm Brady Averill alongside Ryan North. We'll talk to you later.
Thank you for tuning in to tonight's broadcast of Huntington North Lady Vikings basketball on Viking Radio 91.9 WVSH. Before we go, we'd like to thank the following sponsors one more time for making tonight's broadcast possible.
Bailey Love Mortuary, Bippis State Bank, First Federal Savings Bank, Hartburg Roth Garrett Halverstad and Garrett Law, Nove, and Wise Guys Downtown.
Be sure to tune in all season long for the fast-paced action of Lady Vikings basketball on your Huntington North Sports Authority, Viking Radio, 91.9 WVSH.